Hello, brothers and sisters and Heartdwellers family. May you all retreat into your secret place and spend time dancing with Jesus. I went to my phone to check something, then I realized I had Mother Clare's rhema message page open and immediately refreshed into a new message. I was so busy that I just read the title and smiled as it said, Jesus said, may I have this dance? Jesus speaks on what is to come, number 12. I continued on with my day, and it wasn't until in the evening during my adoration time, Holy Spirit brought this message back to my mind. When he did, I knew the Lord was calling me into that intimate place. So I decided to meet him on the ballroom floor to dance with him. So here is the message from Mother Clare.
Well, my much-loved YouTube family, it is Saturday, the 21st of March at 12:30 a.m., and I have a beautiful message for you tonight from the Lord, one that you can really sink your teeth into and that is going to bring you great joy. This time with the Lord tonight began with dancing with him to a song by Terry McAlmon called Praise Him. It's a really beautiful song. I'm going to put it at the end of this message. And we danced, and we danced, and we danced. The Lord was wearing formal military attire, the kind of attire they wear at balls, you know, with the shoulder ornaments and the sword and the banner across his chest, and was all white. He was just absolutely breathtaking, is all I can say. Oh, we danced and danced and danced just to this one song. It's so beautiful. The song is so anointed, and the singers are very anointed. And you'll see that as I play it for you. I think more than anything else, I'd love for you to experience the joy that I experienced. But I put all that aside and I said, please, my King, what do you want me to tell our children? And he began, tell them I'm coming for them. And they will never know the kind of love I have for them until they are on this dance floor in heaven with me. In the meantime, I would like them to make practice runs. Simply go to the holy place of your imagination and visualize a grand ballroom with me standing there in full formal military attire saying, may I have this dance? Bowing before you, I take your hand in mine and gently hold you as we begin to gracefully waltz around the floor. No matter that on earth you could not dance, here in my arms it is second nature to you as we glide along. No matter that you are a man on earth, for these moments in heaven, you are my bride. As you settle into this gentle place with me, our eyes meet, and you begin to feel a fleeting wave of admiration coming from my eyes. Being shy, you dare not look into my eyes for very long, yet. But as the evening wears on, our eyes meet more and more until we are both gazing into one another's eyes, drinking from the deep pools of celestial love for one another. You are now beginning to recognize that I am thoroughly enthralled by you, my priceless creation, and your eyes mirror back to me the profound love that is only now beginning to surface between us. Everything that you've ever sensed or expected about being in love is now blossoming forth into reality, and your relationship with no one less than your God and Creator. Breathlessly, we drink in the growing joy between us until you are completely at home in my arms and all your fears, apprehensions, and self-consciousness is totally a thing of the past. Round and round and round we dance until we are completely inebriated in one another. I lead you out to the rose garden and we sit on the wine-colored velvet love seat, your sweet head resting against my chest and my chin resting in your hair, our eyes closed in blissful satisfaction. From this place, no words are necessary. I have totally captured your love, and you have likewise totally captivated me. We are one. Please, my brides, the day is coming. It is soon approaching. I wish for you to practice yielding to me on the dance floor in preparation for that crowning moment in our lives together. Stay in this place. Drink in my most intimate appreciation and love for you. Absorb it until everything that has kept us apart is gone from your mind forever. And I want to read the scripture to you before we go into the song. I delight greatly in the Lord. My soul rejoices in my God. For he has clothed me with garments of salvation and arrayed me in a robe of his righteousness. As a bridegroom adorns his head like a priest, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels, I will bestow on you a crown of beauty and the oil of joy. You shall wear a garment of praise, for as a young man marries a virgin, so will I marry you. As a bridegroom rejoices over his bride, so do I rejoice over you.
After listening to the message, I imagined myself in a beautiful Victorian ballroom. I was in the powder room, and I knew my beloved Jesus was waiting for me. I began to put my ballroom dress together. It was a red gown, off the shoulder, with a flower lace fabric. It flared out from the waist, with gold underlining and feathers at the bottom. My hair was pinned up, with a red jeweled encrusted headpiece. As I now walked out the room, with butterflies in my stomach, awaiting to meet my beloved, I saw him at the end of the long stairwell that led straight to the ballroom. I felt like Cinderella. No one was there. No one was in the entire room besides me and Jesus, and his gaze was ever fixed on me. He bowed like a gentleman, with his hand out, looking so handsome, with military tuxedo decorated with badges and stripes, and he had white gloves. I walked down slowly, taking in the moment, but also because I was so giddy and nervous all at the same time. When I finally reached the bottom, I put my hands in his hands, and we began to dance and dance. He looked so handsome, and I was holding on to love. What more could I ask for? As I rested my head on his chest, as we waltzed the night away. Finally, after a bit of time, he asked for us to go outside to get fresh air. There was something he wanted to show me. So we went through the corridors of the ballroom, and as we stepped outside to now walk on the steps down to the garden, the steps raised up and became a slide. He grabbed my hand as I was startled, but he just smiled with a sparkle and excitement in his eyes, and we slid down instead as I landed laughing. He then took off his white gloves and his jacket and hung it around my shoulders. I felt so much like young love, so comfortable, so at home, and so in love. He then brought me to this beautiful garden. Everything was so green, and we sat on a bush that was cut out in the shape of a bench. I just rested my head again on his shoulder, not wanting to leave, as I dangled my feet, causing my shoes to fall off and hit the grass below me. I then heard laughter. I looked at Jesus, and he just smiled, as I wondered, where did that come from? He then picked up my shoes and took his shoes off and beckoned me to come with him. I grabbed his hand, coming off this makeshift bench, and the grass beneath my feet was so soft, it began to laugh soon as the soles of my feet touched it. I then bust out laughing, causing me to stumble and step on the grass further, which continued to laugh even more. I realized this was laughing grass. When I raised my feet up, the laughter died down. But as soon as I stepped on it again, laughter would come forth. So what did Jesus do? Jump and walk all over the grass as I joined him, and we both collapsed on the ground in each other's arms as we both continued to reel in laughter and such joy as we rested on one another. And that was the end of my trysting time with Jesus. God bless you, family, until the next diary of our secret place.